Hi, Showtime Onliners! Hello, everybody. I'm finally here again.
Yes!
Yes. Welcome back. Pero ito, syempre, kamustahin muna tayo. Ano bang pinagkakabalaan natin bukod sa pagpropromote ng bagong single?
Okay, so I'm really excited to be here, of course. But lately, I've been, last week, actually, I think that was August 8th, I just finished, ASAP natin to. And also, I want ASAP and, of course, Mix, I've also been doing Kumu streams and TikTok live, ganyan. And of course, I've been busy writing songs since it's pandemic. I took this time to write the songs that I wasn't able to do during the pre-pandemic because I was graduating back then. So, yeah.
Oo. Yung pandemic talaga minsan, no? Binibigyan tayo ng chance gawin yung mga bagay na hindi
totoo
natin ginagawa before.
Yes.
Tama yan, Moira. Pero gusto naming malaman kung sino ba si Moira Lacambra bago pinasok ang music industry.
Okay. But before the showbiz industry, I'm a normal girl. This, actually, bata pa lang ako. This has been my hobby. I've been singing a lot. And I've been on school. Yeah, so like what I said, I'm a 2020 graduate, so I've been busy with school, graduating, ganyan. But yeah, I'm really a normal girl who's been just enjoying life, yeah, and making music.
Wow.
Pero syempre, saan galing yung interest mo sa musika at pagkanta? Namana mo rin ba to? Or workshop, mga ganon?
Actually, nung bata ako, I've started voice lessons really early. And I think, ano na din, dahil na rin sa influence ng tito ko, which is Joey Ayala. And also, sa family namin, very, well, mga Pinoy naman, talaga mahilig sa music, mahilig kumanta. So I guess, isa yun sa reasons kung bakit nahilig ako sa pagkanta, bata pa lang.
Ayun. Pero bukod sa family mo, nabanggit mo nga kanina sa tito mo, pero sino ba yung mga musical influences ko kayo, mga iniidolo mo pagdating sa kantahan?
Madami. Sa local scene, I think I really look up to Miss Casey Tandingan. I think her style is really unique. Of course, Sara G. And yeah, Up Dharma Down, I also like their music. And sa international naman, medyo magkalayo, but I really like Ariana Grande, Kehlani, tsaka si Sela Beyonce, ganun. I really like jumping to different genres to try.
Mm-hmm. So yun, yeah, versatile, no? Pero yes, diba, speaking of music, ano ba ang pangarap mong magawa o ma-accomplish bilang musician or artist balang araw?
Well, of course, I wanna make it to the international scene, like what I said. Hopefully, yung makakarinig ng music ko isn't only yung mga taga-Pilipinas, of course. I want, hopefully it reaches other countries and, yeah. And syempre, ma-promote natin yung OPM sa ibang bansa, di ba? Para support
True.
Local.
True.
Pero ito, pag-usapan naman natin ng latest single na Be With Me. Tungkol ba saan ito?
Okay. So, yeah, I'm here to promote my digital single. Upcoming digital single, which is Be With Me. Actually, I wrote this one during the pandemic. It is about internet love. Basically, LDR kasi sabi ko, lahat, ang daming taong LDR ngayon with their loved ones, not True. Only with their partner, ako nga even with my friends. So sabi ko, siguro maraming makaka-relate, maraming may situation na ganito ngayon. So yeah, but it focuses more on LDR. So basically, two persons that are longing for each other and magkalayo.
Pero balita namin, ito ay ang una mong single na ikaw talaga yung sumulat. Ano naman ang pakiramdam na may kanta ka na ikaw mismo yung gumawa?
Okay, so actually, nag-release na ako ng first single ko, which is First Date. So that was given to me by Mr. Marcus Davis. Kaya lang matagal-tagal na siyang na-release. And finally ngayon, sabi ko nga during pandemic, I was able to put more time in making my music and writing. So, this Be With Me is written by me and arranged by the amazing Mr. Isagani Palabyab. And of course, co-produced by my 18 family, Sirogi, and yeah.
Yun,
Mr. Isagani.
Bongga. Okay. Kung may tao, eto may question kami para sa iyo, Moira. Kung may tao kang sasabihan ng be with me, of course, bukod sa family and friends mo, sino mm-hmm. siya at bakit?
Uy!
Sino yun? Sabihin mo na.
Tay-tay lang.
Aside, tay-tay lang. Aside sa family. Siguro pag pinakinggan nila yung music, mas may intindihan nila yung message ng song. So, I say just to watch out for the song and maiintindihan nila yung what I wanted to relate to the audience or to the listeners of this song.
Hindi nag-name drop.
Safe.
Safe
answer. Safe. Wait, mukhang may twist ha.
Para
oo,
po abang.
Pero ito na yung chance mo. Oo, tama naman. Ito na ang chance mo i-promote ang Be With Me sa ang digital platforms. Ba namin pwedeng abangan yan? At syempre, kailan ba namin mapapakinggan ng buo yan, di ba?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Be With Me, this is my upcoming single which will be released on August 27. Sana po abangan nyo yan. This is gonna be released under Star Music. And the genre of this song is basically contemporary R&B slash soul, so and pop. So sana po abangan nyo yan sa mga may ka-internet love ngayong panahon na to at saka sa mga may ka-LDR or sa mga umiibig na magkalayo. I think you guys can relate to this song. This is arranged and mastered by the amazing Isagani Palabyab. Co-produced, like what I said, by my A-Team family. And what else? Of course, I'd like to thank the people who helped me on this song. Si Solomon, Liam, Kakosria, Young JD, and Miss Bam, and yeah, my A-Team family.
Yun!
How about your social media accounts naman?
Yeah, you guys can follow me on my Facebook. It is Moira La Cambra. On Instagram, Moira La Cambra din. Actually, on everything, on my YouTube, on my TikTok, it is moira.lacambra. So, yeah, abangan nyo po. Be With Me. It'll be out soon. It's showtime! Buong pamilya, buong angkan. Hey! Kasi yan!